In this video, we will study all about normalizing heat treatment. Hi, I'm Dr. Waseem Sheikh. Let us start. Normalizing heat treatment. So normalizing heat treatment, the stages goes like this. First of all, we need to heat the material to a certain temperature range. Then we have to hold it at that temperature and we have to cool it in air. That is the main difference in normalizing heat treatment. The first and second stages is same as most of the heat treatment. The only thing different here than other heat treatment is that we are cooling the material in air. So air is the medium of cooling. For normalizing, the steel is heated above A3 line and ACM line. So unlike what we saw in annealing, that we were just heating the hyper-eutectoid steel just above A1, here that is not the case. For both hypo and hyper-eutectoid steel, we are heating the material in a range where the entire structure is austenite. So at room temperature, after normalizing, what is the structure that we are getting? For hypo-eutectoid steel, we are getting ferrite and perlite. For eutectoid steel, we are getting perlite. For hyper-eutectoid steel, we are getting perlite and cementite. So normalizing differs from annealing only in the rate of cooling. This is the range of heating the material for normalizing heat treatment. So you can see here we are slightly above the range of annealing and we are into the austenitic range for both hypo and hyper-eutectoid steel. From there, the material is taken out of the furnace and it is kept separately and it is cooled in air. The main purpose of annealing is to get a uniform structure and to refine the grain size. So if you know the metallurgical term coarsening and refining, you know that refining means to lower the size of the grain or to have a smaller size grain. Also, steels which are deformed because of rolling and forging operation, what happens is the grains which are formed are very irregular in shape and size, which is generally not desirable. So we carry out normalizing heat treatment and we get very fine structure, very refined grains and equiax grains. Grain refinement is also associated with some sort of hardness. So normally the normalized steel which we have is slightly harder or stronger than the annealed structure. This we have to keep in mind in terms of mechanical property. This is an image which shows the structural changes that happen during normalizing heat treatment. So initially at room temperature, we have the structure which is ferrite and perlite. Above A1, if we heat the material, we are getting austenite and ferrite. Above that, if we heat, the entire material is austenite, that is above A3 or ACM line. After that, when we cool the material in air, we are getting finer perlite. So this image is more or less similar to the one which we saw in an earlier video of annealing. There, the only difference was that the grains which were shown at room temperature after heat treatment were very coarse, and here the grains are very refined. This is a continuous cooling transformation diagram which we are looking here, and here when we see the cooling curve which is superimposed on this diagram, when we are cooling very slowly, we get the annealed heat treatment and we are getting a coarse perlite, and that is what we saw in an earlier video. Now for this, when we are cooling the material in air, what we are getting is we are getting the finer structure. So the time taken is also lesser and the structure we are getting is also finer. Finer structure means that we are having smaller grains and the strength of the material is slightly more than the annealed steel. This is a very important slide here. You have to go through this slide before every examination, because most of the examination for materials and metallurgy, they mainly have questions on annealing and normalizing. So if you go through this slide, you exactly know what are these two heat treatment and how they differ from each other. So starting from normalizing. Normalizing, we are cooling in air. Annealing, we are doing furnace cooling. And the strength achieved in normalizing is slightly more than the annealed steel. Perlite is fine in normalizing and perlite is coarser in annealing. Internal stresses are slightly more in normalizing because we are cooling in air. So the rate of cooling is faster. So there are some chances of internal stresses which can be there in the material. But in annealing, we are doing very slow cooling, so chances of stress, internal stresses are very less. During normalizing, again, we have very faster cooling as compared to annealing. So there is some chance that the property at different places might differ. So you don't have that much of uniform structure or uniform property, you can say. But in annealing, you have more uniform properties which are there. Normalizing is comparatively less expensive because you are not occupying a furnace like annealing. You are just taking the samples out of the furnace. You are keeping it somewhere out for cooling in air. But in annealing, what happens is the entire furnace is occupied. You are keeping the sample in the furnace. You are allowing the sample to cool with the furnace. So the furnace can't be used for any other thing. It is getting occupied by that sample. So the cost increases, and that is how it is more expensive than normalizing. So here is a cooling cycles for different types of heat treatment, right from annealing to normalizing. So annealing, which have four types of annealing, and normalizing. So we can see that we can start from normalizing, that is on the top. We are heating above AC3 and ACM line, and that is the highest temperature we want for normalizing for both hypoeutectoid steel and hyper-eutectoid steel. From there we are doing air cooling. Now we will go to full annealing. In full annealing, for hypoeutectoid steel we are heating above A3. For hyper-eutectoid steel we are just heating above A1. Then after annealing we are just keeping the sample in the furnace, turning of the furnace. So it is called as furnace cooling. The next type of heat treatment is process annealing. So in process annealing you are heating just around a recrystallization temperature. Then we have spheroidizing. In spheroidizing we are heating the material just below the A1 line. Then we have stress relief annealing, which is the lowest in temperature. We are just heating the material to just recovery range so that we can just recover some of the properties of the material and we can relieve the material from internal stresses. So I hope by watching this video you understood what is normalizing and why we are carrying out normalizing and how it is different than annealing. Thanks for watching the video. All the best.